Hi, I'm Josh Ellsworth with Stahls, and welcome to video number 5 in our series of 21 looks. The idea behind these videos is we're giving you all of the trending looks that are happening in 2021. And we're not only teaching you how to print these looks, but we're encouraging you to steal these looks. That means clicking the link below to download a guide and to get marketing assets that you can use on your social media accounts, websites, catalogs, etc. We're on video number 2 into our sports series. Our first 3 looks were in fitness. Look number 4 was in sports, where we decorated this high-end hockey jersey with perforated numbers and another product we call SimStitch. Now, for this video, we're going to be keeping it on the high-end side of sports and showing you a 3D embroidered patch decorated onto headwear. Are you sick of getting the crease on hats when you try to heat press them? Or maybe you've never heat pressed a hat before. It's a real problem that's out there in the market. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can print these high-end retail looks accurately in 1 minute's time. Coming close to our Hotronics 360 IQ hat heat press. The first thing you need to know about this hat heat press is that it's heated from the bottom. It has this dual silicone pad that's a soft landing base that heats up to warm your hat from underneath. And it's actually creating a heat sandwich. Not only does it have the heated lower attachment, but it has the top heated attachment as well. And so that's going to give us accuracy when we're completing our results. Now, these two platens are controlled by the Fusion IQ control panel. This is a touchscreen control panel where you can either use a stylus or you can use your finger to go ahead and set your time temperature settings. Now, this particular application is going to take a full 60 seconds. So I'll tap that on the control board and click the check mark that's what I want it set for. As you can see here, I have my top heat at 280 degrees, my bottom heat at 320 degrees, and the last missing link is the pressure. In order to check the pressure, I'll need to load my cap. This is a Port Authority trucker cap that's a snapback style. It is a structured cap, which means it has a fused buckram that tends to crease when you press it with a normal heat press. Now, when you're loading it onto this press, you first want to flip the sweatband out. Okay? That allows an even pressure on the front placement for my design. I'm going to grab this by the corners and slide it in to my lower base to position it down. I'll make sure the edge of the bill is flushed with this little lip on the lower attachment. And then I'm going to lock down my hold down device here on the right hand side. That makes sure I have good contact. From there, I wiggle the hat just slightly to make sure I have good contact and I'm not getting a bump on my print area. So you just need to kind of work the hat. You don't need to be too delicate with it to get it in a flat printing location. At that point, you need to put on your print pad that you'll be using to complete the application. A few different print thickness pads come with the hat press, and for this one, I'm choosing the medium thickness because it matches the thickness of my 3D embroidered emblem. This is puff embroidery, guys. Really nice, high-quality results that you see on MLB hats, professional-style hats. I'll put my pad into place, and I'm going to complete a preheat, and this is the point where I'm also going to check my pressure. So when I lock the press down, I can see the press is at an overload on the pressure. That's just too much. So I'm going to open the press up and then I'll adjust my pressure. The pressure adjustment on this machine is on the top. I'm just going to turn it counterclockwise to raise this platen. And let's just raise it a little bit. And let's go ahead and load that pad back in and try that one more time. At this point, I'm an 8 on my pressure. This press reads on a scale from 1 to 9. And so I'm looking for something on the firmer side. So anything like a 7, 8, 9 is fine for this application. So pressure locked in, temperature set, timer in place, I'm ready to position my design. In this case, we're going to put this embroidered 3D logo right on the front of the hat. This is designed to be an italicized font, so we're putting it on a little bit of an angle. And you can see I'm holding here just for a few seconds to get contact so it'll hold into place. It kind of melts the adhesive a bit since it's heating from underneath, gets it to hold in place perfectly. At that point, I'm just going to cover it with the pad. Guys, this is so easy. All you do is position it, you lock down the press, and you let the press count down 60 seconds and do all the work for you. We're going to fast forward so you don't have to waste all this time just watching it count down. As the machine approaches 0, it'll beep and then it will automatically open to reveal our completed design. Simply remove the pad, unlock the hold down device from the press, and then I'm going to slide the cap out the same way I put it in. Flip the sweatband back in, and let's take a look at our completed result. you can see a really high-end 3D embroidered effect. Not only is this adhered, but this is going to be something that's highly durable. You can go directly over the seam, even on a 6-panel cap, producing these professional results. So that's video number 2 out of our sports market category in our 21 looks video series. So far in sports, we've shown you this high-end hockey jersey and a high-end 3D embroidered applied patch. If you want to steal these looks and start marketing them to your customers right now, again, just click the link in the description. Make sure you look for video 6, where we'll be showing you about the market of spirit wear.